from WLWT. This is Issues.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to Issues. I'm Curtis Fuller. Thanks for joining us today. Today, we're going to talk about the notion of going green. You hear that phrase often, and involved in that is one school, Bethany School. You're going to hear about a very dramatic program that's taking place out there, and how Duke Energy is involved. So with me this morning is, first of all, David Gould, who is the assistant head of school at Bethany School, and Sally Thielen, who is a company spokesperson for Duke Energy. First of all, welcome to the program.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going to start with the basic of letting people know a little bit about Bethany School, if they don't know. It's been around for many years, of course.
Sure. Bethany School was founded back in the 1890s, actually, by a group of Episcopal nuns who founded the community of the Transfiguration in Glendale. And they started off as a ministry for young girls who were not doing well in their home environments, sort of like an orphanage, but really a home for girls, and a place for children to actually escape the polluted areas of Cincinnati back in those days. And it was sort of like a fresh air camp. Mm-hmm. And eventually they realized that they needed to school the girls as well. And so over the many years that Bethany's been in existence, it eventually morphed into a kindergarten through eighth grade co-ed Episcopal school in Glendale, the only Episcopal school in Ohio.
Very diverse school?
Very diverse school, socioeconomically, racially, religiously. We have a wide variety of families that come from all over the Cincinnati area.
And I mention that because I give this history because I think when you look at Bethany's history and you talk about this project today, people will have a better understanding of the commitment being made by the sisters.
Exactly right. The sisters have made a tremendous commitment over the years of educating students from many different walks of life. And so they draw students who come from very privileged backgrounds, as well as backgrounds that they really struggle. And they've really have created, in terms of their own theology, a harmonious place for families to raise. And in addition to that, what we're doing right now is some work that really sort of extends the sisters' beliefs in the importance of taking care of God's creation. So we have the importance of going green and environmental opportunities and sustainability initiatives that are going as part of this big project that we have underway.
And I know I'm throwing a lot of questions at you, but let me then lead into this project, really, that you're embarking on, and then I can bring in Sally.
Sure. So 3 years ago, we started a master site plan project. We hired Immersion Design, an architectural firm here in Cincinnati, and their lead architect, Christy Boron, and the lead designer, Chad Edwards, really working on looking at what the school needs to look like from a sustainability standpoint in the next 25 to 30 years. Our current campus is a beautiful campus, but also quite old. We have 11 buildings, and many of them were built in the 1920s and 1930s with all the challenges that those quaint buildings come with. So during that time, we really began to talk about what was important for the sisters and what was important to educate these children in a way that was really going to connect them to the environment there on Bethany campus. It's a very beautiful Garden of Eden like environment, beautiful trees and grasses and flowers. And so how to make that an incremental part of the educational experience for our students.
You know, when people hear about people planning 25 years out, it sounds like a long time, but in reality, it's not, because there's a lot that goes into this. Sally, let me have you come in, because Duke Energy will be a big part of this project, but Duke has also been involved in a lot of projects, maybe not to this scale, but let's talk a little bit about how Duke will connect to this and other projects.
Absolutely. We were aware that they were
doing some new work out there at the Bethany School. So we have account managers that reach out and have relationships with many schools in the area and businesses. So when they learned that they were going to be building this new facility out there, we wanted to make sure on the ground level we could get in, take a look at how we could help them potentially with some incentives and whatnot with programs that we have, such as the Smart Saver that I'm sure we'll talk a little bit about here today. But we get in on the front end of the planning with organizations and schools such as the Bethany School, and really it enables them to be able to not only build their facility in a very nice green way, but it also allows them some incentives along the way that through the company, Duke Energy, we're able to help them with.
How widespread are many organizations going green? Now, we hear about that, but...
There are, you would be amazed at how many... Actually, educational institutions are looking for ways that they can incorporate their building footprint into even the curriculum with their schools and students. So some schools in Northern Kentucky, Turkeyfoot, for example, is a very green school that has a lot of energy efficiency on it that we worked very closely with their energy planner for the school system out there for that facility. So we love it when we can get in before projects are really determined so that we can help kind of guide the process and work with them in the process as well.
David, I would imagine the probably the hardest part is getting people to buy into the vision, to let them understand that commitment now means a vision down the road that will be actually will be here long after we're probably gone.
Exactly right, and I think for a lot of people the fear at the outset is how are we going to pay for this without realizing that it's eventually going to be paying for itself down the road. But there is some money that needs to be put up front, and what's been very nice is the sisters' tremendous commitment along with the rest of the school community as we move forward. So we were very deliberate in choosing Immersion Design as our designers, knowing that they came with this array of tools that they could help us put into place. So right from the get-go, from the original designing of the buildings themselves, the arrangement in terms of in relationship to the cardinal directions, the way in which they're enveloping the buildings themselves to make sure that there's the energy efficiencies from placement of windows to how we're dealing with stormwater retention to how we're dealing with the landscaping. Those are all fit into the overall design of the project itself. And this particular building, the first building that we're looking at, ultimately, if everything pans out the way that we hope it will be a net zero energy building and the most energy efficient school building in the state, and probably the second most energy efficient building in the school building in the United States.
Wow, that's very impressive. All right, we're going to take a break and then we'll come back and talk a little bit more about this. I also want to talk a little bit more about the Smart Saver program and how not only can businesses benefit, but also residential customers can benefit as well. Back in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Curtis Fuller. Here with me, David Gould from Bethany School, and also Sally Thielen from Duke Energy. I full disclosure, I should note that my daughter attended Bethany for several years, and so I'm familiar with the school, and I guess I should let you know that. but this is a great story, whether she attended there or not. We're talking about how this school is really taking on a project to go green and in a big way. And I want you to just restate what you said at the end of that segment about this first building and where it will be in relationship to in the state and in the country, because that's an important point to underscore.
It is. And I'd like to also piggyback on a comment earlier that Sally mentioned about Turkeyfoot and the work that they're doing and how we're trying to intermingle it with our education, the active education going on with the students. But as I said before, if all of the sustainability initiatives pan out with this particular building, and there's actually a few buildings that we're looking to build, but this particular building, the grade 3 through grade 8 building, we would actually create a net zero building, which would be the most energy efficient school building in the state of Ohio and the second most energy efficient school building in the entire United States.
Hmm. So, you know, I wonder why more, not just school districts, but why more businesses aren't going in this direction, because, and I guess it is the cost up front that, as you said, you know, frightens people away, mm-hmm. but you have to understand it's going to pay for itself.
And there's definitely businesses, some businesses come to the community and already have a green focus, whether it's their corporate vision or whatnot, and we'll work with certainly any of them on that. We work frequently. One of the customers that comes to mind in Northern Kentucky is L'Oreal. We have relationships with them that we're partnering with them constantly to try and help them be more energy efficient. And they're being an international company. That was hugely important for them. So we like to partner with companies, obviously schools like Bethany, and we've already talked about some in Northern Kentucky. But any time that we can help schools be more energy efficient, businesses be more energy efficient, it puts less demand on our system. So ultimately, we like to say it would save us from having to build another power plant, you know, down the road so that we can meet the needs of our customers.
We'll get back to the cost of this project, because that's important for people to understand about the cost and how they can help. Smart Saver. People have heard about this, but explain what Smart Saver is, and it's not just some corporate project.
Right. It can be for residential customers or for business customers. If you wanted more information, you can just go to our website, look under Duke Energy, look under products and services, or even just simply search Smart Saver. At that point, you can go to the residential section or you can go to a business section. You can drill down into whatever type of business, for example, that you may own, and it will give you specific worksheets that you can fill out of the types of lighting on your premises. We can come in, do an assessment and look at things that you might probably expect: lighting, HVAC. If you're a school, we'd be looking in the cafeteria area at what types of equipment are in there, refrigeration. We do water chilling units, a lot of that sort of thing. So big ticket items that we can come in, make a big difference with bringing in LED lighting and much more efficient appliances. And that is the same thing if you look at on the residential side. If a customer is going to be looking at doing an upgrade to their home, a remodel, for example, and they're thinking about getting a new HVAC unit or hot water heater, definitely go to our website, take a look, make sure that what you're looking at purchasing would qualify for a potential Smart Saver rebate. I've done that in the past year at my own home, and it was a very easy process.
I get this fact sheet in the mail every month, and it tells me how I'm doing in terms of energy in my own home. And I'm probably average. But when I see that I come below the average, you know, home or the energy most efficient home, then you know you're doing something right. And
exactly.
and you can make a difference. I do want to ask you, with the summer coming up, people are probably concerned how they can save this summer, some things that they should do. I just want to throw that in, because that's good information for them to know. I know that there are programs out there to assist people. So let me just get that before I forget.
Sure. Definitely, we've got a ton of tips for whether it's winter weather, whether it's summer weather, on our webpage, tips to save money, save energy. And you know, your first one, I would say, when you're gearing up for the summer, for the peak use of your air conditioner, you want to make sure it's working properly and optimally, making sure that you're replacing your filter frequently. That's certainly something that we see. You want to make sure that you're closing your blinds if you're wanting to try and keep as much of the cool air in your home. You want to close the blinds if they're facing the sun out there. You know, certainly fans can help circulate cool air during the day, depending on you know, what customers might feel comfortable with. We want everybody to not do something that's going to make them super uncomfortable in their home. Look at using your appliances. If you're going to be using an oven, you're obviously going to be heating up your kitchen a lot. So using smaller appliances like toaster ovens or microwaves in the summer months would help. And if you're someone that I don't think a lot of folks are out there, but if you haven't switched to using CFLs or LEDs, just the traditional incandescent bulb puts off so much more heat, you'd be amazed. So even just making a switch to lighting makes a big difference as well.
At one point, you were allowing customers to, and I'm not sure if that's a Smart Saver program or not, I don't think it is, but where during some of the peak periods,
yes,
the company would automatically reduce the
right. And you're speaking of the device that we can actually affix onto your air compressor on your air conditioning unit. It's really not a huge deal in terms of what our feedback has been from most customers. We'll cycle off your compressor on your AC unit, usually twice in a half an hour. Typically never more than about six times in a summer, but depending on how the summer heating heats up with Mother Nature, I think last year we activated the program probably about three times. So not a whole lot here because it was a fairly mild summer, but that's a program that will come out, take a look, make sure that your unit is qualifies for us to be able to install it. Typically older units may not be something that we could install it on, but it's something that will give you an incentive for a one-time incentive to do it, and then most people just feel good about helping us take some of the demand off of our system when we need it.
Excellent. We're going to take a final break, and then when we come back, I want to talk about cost, how you're going to make this work, how people can get involved in it. I also want to point out Community Action Agency is a good agency that can assist you if you're having some issues with your energy bills. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. I'm Curtis Fuller, David Gould, Sally Thielen. Sally's with Duke Energy. David is with Bethany School, talking about a project that really is a visionary project looking forward, what Bethany is doing, trying to really take the lead, if you will, in energy, going green. Again, this project, give us a timeline, give us an idea of cost, and how people can get connected to this.
As I said, this is a process that we're going through.
Yeah.
And the master site plan started about 3 years ago, and right now we're in an active capital campaign phase to actually raise funds to actually make this this project a reality. We've gone public with our campaign, and our hope is that we're actually gonna be breaking ground on the grade 3-8 building this September. That's our hope. But in the meantime, we are in the process of working with the sisters to actually do some campus-wide infrastructure projects. So one of them is actually a geo exchange well field that we're building to actually provide energy for the HVAC units throughout the entire campus itself. We're looking at 110 wells, one of the a tremendous project, in addition to some work that we're going to be doing with our stormwater retention and things of that nature. The entire master site plan project that Bethany is raising funds for is a $13 million project. Mm-hmm. The grade 3-8 building is about $4 million. And I've been asked to, in terms of the energy efficiencies that we do, how much of that makes up the $4 million of that building. It's very hard to say because we really started off at the very beginning in terms of the design. Mm-hmm. And one of the things that we're actually reaching for with this building is LEED certification. So, and that goes into the entire design and enveloping of the project itself, of that particular building. So it's hard to really decipher, but I would say about $300,000 is really wrapped up into those initiatives that are really looking at making this building a net zero building. Mm-hmm. And when it comes to the Smart Saver program, the preliminary work that we've been doing with Duke Energy is we're looking at some different bundle packages, some custom bundle packages for Bethany School, three of them, and we're looking at some energy savings from anywhere from about $20,000 per year to going up to $40,000. So we're in the process of trying to figure out what exactly we're going to be doing, but we feel very, very hopeful with where we are right now.
And this really is the discussion. It is the discussion now, but this kind of conversation is the future. I mean, everyone will
exactly
be having
right.
this kind of conversation looking forward, I would imagine. Huh?
And David and I were speaking earlier. We actually, ironic that we're talking with you today, but even later today, we have folks that are meeting with the school to take a look at the overall campus to see what other areas, just not maybe not new construction, but other ways that we can save. So any time we can partner with schools, with local businesses, it's critical to helping everybody save energy and be more energy efficient.
And you mentioned Turkey Foot. Any idea of how many other schools in the area? I'm just curious.
I would say since probably in the last 10 years, what we're seeing that would give you a good indicator of that, there are actually energy operations managers for school systems. So I would say there's at least probably 6 to 8 of those that I'm aware of. And anytime, I say Kenton County because Joe Chavez out there has been very aggressive in helping outfit some of their schools and remodeling projects to be very energy efficient. But certainly, I would say that in the last 10 years, it's becoming more popular than you'd think. 10, 12 years ago, that wasn't really a position in a school or at a school system that you would hear of. And it's certainly much more common now.
And I would imagine even municipalities will start. This is, again, something we will hear. This kind of conversation.
Oh, sure.
Moving forward.
Well, and what's exciting about Turkey Foot and Sally hinted at it earlier on was the fact that I see this really as having a significant impact upon the educational experience of our students. Right. Certainly, from a purely science instruction standpoint, is that we're going to be living within an environmental laboratory for our science teachers to really be able to go outside and look at how we're taking care of irrigation and stormwater retention. And the monitors that we're going to be having throughout the buildings themselves to see where is our energy efficiencies being challenged and what can we do to help out in other ways. So that's a very exciting process. Plus, the way in which this building is designed is that we are creating a much more optimal educational environment for our students to really really study in, and for the adults to actually work in. That's very exciting.
Give an address or a number, website, so people can get in touch with you if they want more information.
Bethany School is in Glendale in the northern reaches of Cincinnati. It's www.bethanyschool.org, or you can reach us out at area code 513-771-7462.
All right. I'll give the number just one more time. I think
513-771-7462.
All right. I think people know how to reach Duke Energy.
They know where to find it.
They know where to find you. Hey, thank you very, very much. And we'll keep up with the project going forward.
Thank you, Curtis.
Back in a moment. Well, that just about does it for the program today. I thought this was just an interesting topic because, again, these are the type of conversations we'll be having going forward. So that does it for the program today. I'm Curtis Fuller. Have a nice week.